The death of a disco. Closed doors, an unsound structure, and hardly an indication of what used to happen here. But for decades, this building played host to thousands of people during the golden period of nightlife in the seaside resort of Salthill.
Something different on every night. It wasn't the same. So you had a lot of the best DJs in the west of Ireland, or even all over Ireland, playing here. In the mid-late 90s, the whole of Salthill had a reputation for a fantastic club scene, and this was just one of the places.
In the 1980s and 1990s, there were close to a dozen nightclubs operating within a one-mile radius of the Oasis. Crowds flocked to the village in search of romance, a dance, or even what was described as a substantial meal, an element of the licensing laws that food be served to customers attending discos.
But the good thing about back then was just whatever you felt like. You know, some nights you feel like you might want a covers band, some nights you might want to watch an indie band, some night you want techno or house. You could get everything, all on one street, and chips and burgers and whatever you wanted as well. So that was the benefit, that was the beauty of it back then.
This isn't the first venue to fall victim to the times. Last year, the neighbouring Warwick Hotel was knocked, and elsewhere in the city, the former Corrib Great Southern Hotel is also on the list for demolition in the near future.
Places like the Oasis operated in simpler times, in the days before text messaging, camera phones and social media. While the wrecking ball will take away the bricks and mortar here in the coming months, it can't touch the memories held by thousands of people who revelled here over the years. Pat McGrath, RTE News, Salthill.